Good morning, everybody. We are going to start with first chapter of civics of 8th standard, that is the Indian Constitution. Now, before we come into the chapter, let us see what is Constitution. So, you have already studied in smaller classes that Constitution is a set of rules and regulations according to which a country is governed. Every country has its own constitution, whether it is a democratic country or not a democratic country. Of course, India is a democratic country, so we have a constitution. Even some countries which do not have democracy also have their constitution, and some countries are called as constitutional monarchy also because they run according to constitution, but the ruler is the king. So democracy always have a constitution. Since India is a democracy, we have a constitution. Now the main question is, why do we need constitution? So three reasons we can quote for why do we need constitution. The first and the foremost reason why constitution is necessary is that it lays out certain ideas that form the basis of the kind of country that we as citizens aspire to live in. The sentence seems to be a little complicated, but I will explain you through example. Like, there are some aspirations, that means what is our need, what we want our country to be. During the freedom struggle, Mahatma Gandhi emphasized on ahimsa, that is non-violence. And this non-violence was later on incorporated in our constitution also. So all the aspirations of the freedom strugglers, that means those who struggled for India's freedom, whatever they wanted India to be, whatever they wanted to aspire India to be, that all ideals were incorporated in the constitution. We as Indians want India to have equality. We want justice, we want liberty. So these are some of the ideas which we aspire to live in. We want to live in such a society where there is freedom, where there is security, where there is equality, justice. So these are the ideas which we aspire to live in, and such ideas are incorporated in the constitution. So constitution is necessary because it gives us an idea that what kind of society we want to live in. Then the second cause for why do we need constitution is it defines the nature of a country's political system. That means looking at the constitution, we can find out what type of political system that country is following, whether it is monarchy, whether it is democracy or any other form of government. If we look at India's political system, we can find that India is a democracy. That means the people of India want a democratic form of government. So what we want, what is our political system, is mentioned in the constitution. Nepal was monarchy few years back, but the people did not like it. So they had a revolt, they changed the form of government, and now democracy is a form of government in Nepal. So if we look at the present constitution of Nepal, then the country's political system is democracy. So democracy is what people wanted to aspire to live in. So they made changes in the political system and made it as democracy. Now if we talk about India, India's political system is democratic form of government, and we have our own constitution also. In the constitution, it is specially mentioned about universal adult franchise. Our political system is such that anybody can stand for election, and everybody above 18 years of age has the right to vote. So universal adult franchise is one of the features of our political system. Then because of this political system and because these things are mentioned in the constitution, we have some advantages also. Because of our constitution, it prevents the misuse of authority. Let me explain you with one example. If in a class I make a child a monitor, But if the monitor does not like some child in the class, he may complain about that child to the teacher, even if that child has not made any mistake. So just to take revenge, he may complain about the child to the teacher. And teacher, without knowing the reason and without finding out the fact, may scold the child whose complaint was given by the monitor. So what happens in this case? The child who is monitor is having authority, power. So he is misusing his power. So this type of problem will not occur if constitution is there. That is why we need constitution. If constitution is there, misuse of authority will not take place. Those who are having power, those political leaders, will not be able to exploit the common people, because there are provisions in the constitution which says that everybody is equal. It also helps us that dominant group cannot use their power against the common people. For example, in a class there are more boys and less girls, and boys want to play football but girls want to play volleyball. The teacher can allow them to play only one game. So who is majority here? Boys. So boys want to play football. So usually what happens, that everybody is asked to play football because the majority wants that. But this is not good. So in our constitution, to avoid this, even the minorities are given power. It is ensured that the majority will should not always prevail. The minorities should also have their will to be prevailed. So in our constitution, some reserved constituencies are given to the smaller sections like scheduled caste and scheduled tribes, so that they are also dominated in the country's political system, and the dominant group cannot misuse their power and suppress the people of the smaller classes. So this helps us to know that it defines the nature of country's political system. Now the third reason why Indian constitution is required is it protects us from ourselves. This is little complicated term, but easy to understand. It may happen that sometimes people who live in democracy are fed up of democracy, because they think democracy is all about political power play, and there is always conflict between different political parties, and there are so many problems related to political parties. So it may happen that at one point of time you may think to change the nature of the country's political system from democracy to dictatorship. This may happen. But we know that if dictatorship comes, in the long run it will be harmful for the country. But because of our immediate feeling, we want dictatorship to come. But it is not easy to change the Indian constitution and convert it into dictatorship. So Indian constitution has some features which makes it very difficult to change the type of political system the country is having. So in fact, it is good that it is not easily amendable. If it would have been easily amendable, we would have easily shifted to dictatorship, which will ultimately lead problem to us. So because the constitution is difficult to change, so it is good for us because it is saving us from ourselves, from our bad thinking, from our feelings of misusing the power. So it is good that constitution has some provisions which does not help it to change easily. So this helps us to save us from the bad decisions which we may take. So these are the three reasons why do we need constitution. The second important topic of this chapter is the Indian constitution key features. Let us look into the five important features of Indian constitution which makes it very different from other constitutions. First one is federalism. What do you mean by federalism? The existence of more than one level of government is called as federalism. In India, we have a central government and many state governments, and below the state governments, we have local governments also. So this type of power sharing, where there are different levels of government, is called as federalism. We have central government. There are certain laws which are made by the central government. There are certain subjects on which only central government can make law, like defense is one such topic on which only central government can make law. But there are certain areas where the state governments are allowed to make laws. So when the power is distributed to the state government, then it is referred to as federalism. Now many of the state governments exercise their power with the help of local government. So local government is the third form of, or the third level of government. So the distribution of power between central, state and local level is called as federalism. So this is not available in many of the countries. In many of the countries there is only one level, that is central level, and they do not share power with the state or the local government. So since we share the power, we call it as federalism. The second feature of Indian constitution is, it is a parliamentary form of government. Unlike USA, which is having a presidential form of government, we are having parliamentary form of government. That means in our country, president is not supreme, parliament is supreme. And parliament is an elected body. People choose their representatives with the help of universal adult franchise, and the parliament rules the country, and the representatives or the parliament are chosen by the people, and anybody can vote also who is above 18 years of age, and anybody can stand for the election also without having any distinction between race, caste, religion, sex or place of birth. So since all of them can stand for election and all of them can vote also, and it is the representatives who run the country, this type of government is called as parliamentary form of government, where parliament is supreme. So this is one of the feature of Indian constitution. Then the third feature is separation of powers. In India, unlike in monarchy, the power is not concentrated in one person. The power is distributed among three organs of the government, that is legislature, executive and judiciary. The work of the legislature is to make laws, work of the executive is to execute or implement the laws, and the work of the judiciary is to protect the laws. So the power is not concentrated in one hand, it is divided among legislature, executive and judiciary. And the constitution ensures that none of them become more powerful than the other. So each one of them check each other's power, and so a balance of power is maintained between these. Balance of power is maintained between these three organs of the government. Since each of them keeps check on each other, it is also called as checks and balances. So distribution of power between legislature, executive and judiciary is called as separation of powers, which is one of the important key feature of Indian constitution. Then one more key feature is fundamental rights. We have given major six fundamental rights to the Indians. We can write the short form of all the fundamental rights, EFECC. That means right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, freedom of religion, cultural and educational right, and right to constitutional remedies. These are the six rights which are mentioned in our constitution, and they are called as fundamental rights. These fundamental rights help any Indian citizen to lead a peaceful and harmonious life because no distinction is made between on the basis of caste, religion or race. The fifth feature of Indian constitution is secularism. Secularism word is related to religion. In India, we do not give importance to any one religion. We have no state religion. Unlike in Pakistan and many Arabian countries where Islam is the state religion, in India we don't have any state religion. All religious people, Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, Christians, Parsis, Jains, all live harmoniously in India and nobody is given special preference. Anybody can practice any religion. If people want, they can change their religion. They can set up their religious institutions wherever they want. The only thing is the government will not promote any one religion. So there is no religious teaching in any of the government schools. But the private institutions can be set up for teaching their religion. They can propagate their religion. They can practice their religion, and if they want, they can change their religion. So secularism means giving equal importance to all religion, and there is no state religion. So India is called as a secular state because there is no state religion and no religion is given importance. So these are the five features of Indian constitution. So here we end up with the chapter. So there are only two major topics in this chapter, that what is constitution, why do we need constitution, and Indian constitution's key feature.